Alright guys, this video might be a little bit weird, might look a little funky, but at least my voice sounds good, right? I didn't want to record on my voice recorder because you could hear absolutely everything in the background, and let's be honest, I sound like shit. Let's not make it worse. Alright, so let's talk DMZ. I've thought long and hard about this video, and I've been playing DMZ since it dropped. Since it came out, I pre-ordered MW2 and hated it. I wasn't a big fan of Search and Destroy, which is absolutely my favorite. DMZ dropped, and I haven't played anything since. Alright, what is the future of DMZ with MW3? Okay, Activision did tweet out that they're going to continue to support DMZ even through MW3, but has not elaborated on pretty much anything else, like what they're gonna do, they mean, or the server's gonna be up. They haven't elaborated. It's yet to be seen, pretty much. So I just wanted to talk to you about some stuff that I'm having some trouble with, some things I would like to change, and my thoughts on whether or not DMZ is going to be viable or continue. I think this might be a little too loud for you guys. I'm gonna turn it down. Hopefully that's okay. First and foremost, DMZ was in beta for way too long, and I understand that they didn't really do a looter shooter, but there's lots of looter shooters they could have chose from to kind of take examples of, and a bunch of other stuff. There are too many small to mid-sized maps now. We have Koshi Complex, Vondel, Building 21, and Sheikah Island. That's four small to mid-range size maps, which is just increasing the shotgun meta that has unfortunately taken over DMZ. First, it was the KV broadside. Was broken then. Still broken now. Any way you cut it, it's broken. Alright? And now, they decided to introduce the one thing that would make the Lockwood 300 better than it was, because it was not that great to begin with. Let me tell you, I believe the last two Call of Duties literally had a problem with 7.25s, right? And that was a double barrel shotgun, looked almost exactly like the Lockwood, and then they just fucking did it again. They were like, you know what, shotgun meta, that's fucking amazing. Alright, I pretty much rage quit earlier and went to play Skyrim because I ran into two teams. Two of them have KB broadside, they all have riot shields, and one has a one-shot shotgun, and I'm just not fucking good with it, alright? I posted a video of the shotgun after it was nerfed, and trust me, it is not. The one-shot shotgun is still kicking just as much as it was before. Alright, so let's talk about something that I know I do too much of probably in DMZ. People don't like it. I PvP a lot. Okay, a lot. We need consistent wipes of barters, flash insured weapons to keep players on track on new missions and stuff to unlock. Otherwise, all we're gonna do is PvP. That's all we're gonna do. It's unfortunate, but it happens. Okay? On that note, every season I feel like there should be a new faction mission added into DMZ to supply how you get your insured weapons back and how you get those bartering items back. So it's not the same consistent thing over and over again, while rewarding players with new and new blueprints and new collectible things they can get in the game. I don't know about you guys, but I've ran into a lot of modders slash hackers lately, especially Season 5. Season 5 has been crazy. Had one on my team, reported him. He got kicked, thank God, because that doesn't always happen, by the way. You have to be reported a little bit for cheating before you actually get kicked out of the game. So luckily, mine was the last one. And he got thrown out of my team. And we squad wiped. He was the last alive, and we squad wiped, and I reported his ass because that's scummy as hell, and I'm not fucking dealing with it. I don't care if I die and lose all my shit, alright? Rotating spawns, super important. You notice in this video, I spawned on the boat. I'll tell you exactly where two spawns are that I'm going to directly push. The main one is the buy station, right? That, from the boat pushing to the buy station, is the easiest push ever. Jump off the boat, parachute, you're pretty much right there, dude. Hard aim the window, other dude jumps in, you got one knocked, you got a teammate going up the ladder already. They two meet on the roof, they get there about the same time. You go up the ladder on that buy station, it's a problem. Everybody knows spawns now, alright? I'm telling you, if you stay in your spawn for any period of time, you're probably going to come and get wiped, alright? Unfortunately, it might be me doing it. Or you could beat me. I'm not invincible. Okay, rangefinder. That thing is a fucking problem. Not as much as the fucking one-shot shotguns, but I'm telling you, getting hit 900 meters out really pisses you off. And there's no fighting it, right? Because if you have a good sniper, I mean, especially when you add aim assist into it, right? You have the rangefinder and you add aim assist into it. 900 meters out, they shouldn't be able to hit me for shit. Alright? Tell me why I'm pinned into a building until I can get a vehicle just to go try to push them and get sniped out of the car. Alright? It's not fucking cool. What I would like to see changed on that is either a nerf to the how much range it can actually shoot, or a sniper range nerf, or, and this is a big one because people are going to hate it, if you use that fucking scope, you don't get any aim assist. None. I don't want none. I play on keyboard and mouse. I have none. I'm just fine. Can't snipe for shit. But any other time, I'm good. All right. Please make some kind of change to the rangefinder. Being sniped in Almazra is like getting bit by 100 Texas mosquitoes. All right. They're giant. Let's talk about the chat moderation thing. Okay, some good, some bad. You know, First Amendment, say whatever the fuck you want. Woohoo! Let's do that, right? Activision wanted to sell to Microsoft. Microsoft said, hey man, y'all got a really big toxicity problem. Alright, cool. Call of Duty's always been like that, to be honest with you. Always. Like, these lobbies aren't nothing compared. Nothing compared to old Call of Duty lobbies. Stop complaining, don't be a baby. Suck it up, take that shit off, because I am tired of losing the situational awareness from a false report or just the AI being buggy since it's new. I'm tired of being comms banned. Tired of it. It's happened 3 times, and I swear to God, all of them, I was innocent until proven guilty, all right? Oh, yeah, and there's absolutely no way to appeal it either, right? You can't go on their website, and you can't be like, look, man, your bot messed up. I'm comms banned for a month. Please let me be able to communicate and actually play the game the way I want to, because my favorite thing is hearing people's reaction when I kill them and take their stuff. All right? That's my thing, man. I like it, right? I like recording reactions for YouTube. Xbox sucks, and you can't hear nobody but me, so blame them on that one. All right? My old content, you can see it. Pre-made six-mans. And at first you're going to go, well, Roosty, they changed the party size to 4. Well, yes, they did. Okay? But they didn't do the obvious fix. They didn't take that little number at the bottom of the screen that you can see on the bottom left and just remove that from me being able to see it. Well, what does that have to do with anything? Well, I'll tell you. A week after they made that change, me and my buddy Gooch ran into a pre-made six-man. Well, how did they do it? Well, they spawned in, went and teamed up, had a 4-man already, and then the two that weren't on the team, they would sit back under something, wait for the other team to push. If they died, they'd go help, etc., etc. It was still a pre-made six. I had these dudes sending bomb drones at me from underneath this building, these two players that weren't on the actual team. I had 4 players pushing me, and 2 under sending kill streaks my way. Right? And bomb drones. They know whose player is who. Alright? It's bullshit. Another thing to add, stop this pay-to-win shit, man. Stop it. All right, I understand. We all like money. But if you're going to make the cost of a UAV be this insane, please don't have somebody pay $20 to spawn in with one every round. And to top that one off, you're hurting everyone because when I spawn in, by the time I push another team normally, that UAV is readily available to be called in. Now I've got a UAV. Okay? Stop it. It's not cool. Alright? Make Stealth Vest and Comms Vest encrypted items spawn in locked spaces, requiring more time to clear those locked spaces before you can build a Stealth over Comms Vest, right? Maybe, maybe not. That one's kind of 50-50. I really don't care, but if you wanted to slow down players, make loot a little bit harder to get, because we're going in and we're looting for things to barter, right? I'm not going to Koshi Complex and messing with the damn diamond drill bit to go get a stealth vest. Matter of fact, half the time I know that, oh, a stealth vest is only, you know, chlorine and black server tape, and it's only going to take me like 15 minutes to do it, but I'm not going to go to Koshi and do that. I'm going to grab one acidic acid and make it a tempered vest and get out, and then I'm going to go back into Almazra. I'm going to kill the next team I see, and I'm going to have a stealth vest. Simple, right? No pleas for help. People probably aren't going to like this one, but how many times have you fought a team, say they instigated it, right? And they pled for help, and then they're typing in chat, please help me, please help me. These guys are frats. These guys are doing this, that, and the other. And three teams show up out of nowhere because they can't be plea because it announced it so far away. So if you're not going to get rid of pleas, at least make the range that I can see them less. Please. Can't be that hard, right? Maybe like, what, 300 meters? That's double the size of the UAV, right? So I'm not having dudes in Turok come push me at airport because they saw somebody was playing. I don't know. Just me. More milsim slash camo operators. Now that I would really appreciate. Some of these characters look goofy. All right. Getting kind of tired of that bunny skin. All right. It's freaky. The cat skin is worse. I don't know. Something about the eyes, man. The eyes. I don't know. Just a walking, talking human cat gives me the creeps. All right. More milsim slash camouflaged operators. And why? Well, you want to support your solo population, right? Like your game has quite a bit of solos, okay? Well, wouldn't it be beneficial for them to be able to actually hide and sneak around better, right? Probably, yeah. So, add more camouflage milsim operators that's harder to find. Also, the backpacks are yellow, dude. It is so irritating. I mean, you can see in this video right now, I'm literally getting sniped from like 600, 700 meters out. That is ridiculous. I'm just running. I'm not even messing with them. They're just sniping. Anyway, the backpacks are yellow. All right. If you're hiding in a bush, you're not hiding very well. All right. That thing sticks out like a sore thumb. Let's talk about these PvP DMZ YouTubers. And you're about to say, well, Roosty, you're kind of in that category. Yeah, true. I am kind of in that category. However, I do not play solo and then act like a god when I 1v6 a team. All right? In a bot lobby. I don't know how many players... Not players, excuse me. I don't know how many PvP YouTubers that started taking off from DMZ content because they were 1v6ing. That have just up and disappeared after the four-man team change and then saying it's boring. Well, 1v6ing, while yes, hard, it's not impossible if you're a semi-decent player, especially if you don't do very many missions. Yeah, your skill-based matchmaking in DMZ is pretty low. You know, we were testing a theory where we put on a tier 1 mission. We put on a tier 1 mission to see if we would spawn with somebody that had tier 1 missions. Guess what? It works. Please do not believe everything you see on YouTube. All right. My clips may look like I'm a god, but I'm probably not. All right. I die just as much as the next person, okay? They're quitting DMZ because of the lack of six mans, even though that is a monumental change to the game. A 1v4 is so much better than a 1v6, all right? That helps the economy of the game, makes it a little less PvP. The price increases, honestly, they're pretty great. I'm happy with it. Way less LTVs around, blah, 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 blah. But I think it's bullshit. I hope you think it's bullshit too, that all these PvP YouTubers are just dipping because the lack of six mans, they don't look like the most amazing person on the internet. Okay, what's next? I've got a whole list over here. I'm reading. All right. I wrote this up right before this video. Make hostage rescues invisible on the map. Okay. I'm not necessarily saying make it completely invisible, but please make it so the entire map can't see it. Maybe if you're in kind of range of it, that would be a little more acceptable. But I don't know how many people I've killed on a hostage expo when I saw it from 500, 600 meters away, and I just took a dirt bike up there and took me 1 second, and I got there before them, and then I killed an entire team trying to exfil. Oh, guess what? They just looted up. They got mission items, right? Well, I need those mission items. I'm going to take it from them. Realistically, the fastest way to loot up is kill another team with gear. That's a little problem. Maybe. I don't know. I like it. It's efficient. All right, fix the Koshi glitch. I'm sure this has happened to you, but have you ever just spawned in, fresh wipe, and you're fighting a team that is dog shit, but they just seem to never run out of plates? Yep, they probably Koshi glitch with an inventory full of plates, 10 airstrikes, 3 UAVs, a shit ton of self-reses. They're going to be sitting up on top of that building sniping you for a while, buddy. I guess you better run. Well, it's too late now because you have a teammate knocked, right? And then it's boring if you sit there and run the whole game. Might as well just go die then, right? Okay. I have mentioned this before, probably not in a YouTube video, but I would be very interested, even though I would be on the bandit side of this, or like the villain side of this, introduce some kind of identification for friendly or aggressive players. Okay, so DayZ did this where you have hero skin and a bandit skin. I understand everyone loves their skin in Call of Duty. I'm not saying, oh, let's force them to have a skin. Okay, I'm not saying that. What I am saying is that I'm sure you can add a red or a blue sash to either their arm, their leg, or a bandana on their forehead, or some kind of indication that I can see visually what kind of players they are. Because, admittedly, and I've been this scum too, I have yelled friendly, friendly, and I was not friendly, friendly, alright? To the point that when DMZ started, there was so many players going friendly, friendly, and now, I don't think I hear it at all. I mean, I'm comms banned, so, but I can't remember the last time that I've heard somebody say friendly, friendly. I don't. That's not even a thing anymore. Okay? Pay attention to this part of the video. That solo that passed me on the dirt bike, I actually came back. And you'll see me crouch in here and then just take off on my bike. It's because he was sitting on the roof above me, waiting to kill me. Okay. Limit how much cash you can stack on top of your full bank. Right? Cash is pretty plentiful. There's still a Koshi money glitch that's going on right now. Granted, it is nerfed, but you know, just like the Lockwood nerf the other day, the nerf didn't do shit in reality. Okay, I've still got 180 grand from that fucking thing. Can't tell me that. All right. And if anyone that's interested, I have a Discord server that you can join that has tips and tricks on glitches and if they work or not, and etc. Tip free, anything. We got key and weapon trading. We got a whole community over there, and I would really love for you to join. All right? We're doing great over there. I'd appreciate a visit at least. Okay. Improve weapons found inside supply crates, making use of more SAM sites. If you hit a SAM site, you're probably going after the commando healer. This is where I heard him walking around, by the way. He's either on top of me or above me. Unfortunately, it's hard to figure out because it all sounds the same. There's no depth to these ammo depots. Limit how much cat... No. Improve weapons found inside supply crates. Make it use some more SAM sites. If I see you hit a SAM site, I'm assuming the commander helo is after. Alright, that's the only time. Yeah, unless you're maybe bored, right? But let's be honest, bot weapons suck, stronghold weapons suck, raid stash weapons suck, building 21 weapons suck. They all suck, alright? They're not great. Improve the weapons, or maybe add just unique blueprints or just random blueprints that you already have in the game and supply drop so players can go after them and they can try a new gun, adding variety to the guns used in DMZ outside of your insured weapons, because I'll be damned if I'm gonna fight somebody with a fucking RPK than a bot drop. Alright? I'm about to explode, I gotta hurry up. For the love of God, stop nerfing me. Stop taking my fucking guns at the beginning of the game, alright? Shit pisses me off. Fix that already. Fix loot disappearing. I don't know how many times my stealth vest disappeared when I was down, or a car blew it up, or they set a mortar strike and it blew my loot up. What the fuck is that? Alright? And for the love of God, remove the option for teammates not on your friends list to open your backpack, because I don't know how many times somebody has stole all my shit and then went straight and exfilled with it. New guns that drop that I spent a long time unlocking, or say I bought the battle pass, my random teammate with no mic sees that I have that new gun and he understands that he can exfil with it, he's going to take my new gun and run. Alright? That's bullshit. That's not cool. I understand the need of getting inside your teammates' bag sometimes. I do it a lot. Oh shit, I need ammo. Oh, I need a gun. Oh, I need a self-res. Oh, I need plates. Do you have plates? Oh, I have an advanced UAV in my bag. Go in my bag. If you get the chance, get in my bag. I got an advanced UAV. I understand that. And that's why I added on your friends list. Alright? Because if they're not on your friends list, their chances are they're probably random. Chances are they don't care about you. Chances are they have a migraine, just aren't talking. Man, I didn't realize I was going to talk for 20 minutes straight doing this, but I'm sure I missed quite a bit. Please, down in the comments, let me know what you thought of this video. If there's any improvements that you can think of, if there's anything you disagree with, tell me why in the comments. I would be happy to reply and try to figure some stuff out. But what is DMZ looking at MW3 future? I don't know, but for me, I think I'm done with it. I think I'm done. I think I'm no longer going to be playing DMZ after MW3 fully drops. Thanks for watching, guys.